Assalamualaikum everyone. Now I'll be evaluating the radiographic image evaluation of libraries. We'll start off with the projection. Okay, this is the projection of a lateral ridge. And first, we must ensure that the distal end of scaphoid and the PC form are superimposed. Ensure that radius and ulna are superimposed to each other. Radius and ulna is right here. A quarter of distal radius ulna and half of the proximal metacarpals are included. The ulna styloid here must be in profile. Next, with the positioning, lateral ridge. Relationship between PC form and distal portion of the scaphoid informs us regarding the rotation of ridge. They must be superimposed to each other. Absence of superimposition notifies us the presence of rotation of the ridge. So this is an example of an axillary rotation. States here that distal scaphoid, so scaphoid, visualize posterior to the PC form. Basically, scaphoid diambarkan belakang PC form. So PC form is this part here, is a semicircle part. The scaphoid is the one right here, the sharp one here. Okay, that is the scaphoid. And that works for external rotation. For internal rotation, distal scaphoid visualize anterior to the PC form. So, you can see the sharp point again, the sharp point. So, this is the scaphoid, but you can't see the PC form as the scaphoid is already visualized in front of the PC form, blocking the PC form from being radiographed in this image. Next, where I'm going to evaluate the image that I will be using. So, scaphoid and PC form are superimposed to each other. Okay, you can see there the scaphoid, the sharp one, and then this is the PC form, the semicircle one. Okay, they are superimposed to each other. Next, radius and ulna superimposed to each other. Therefore, concluding that there are no signs of rotation in this image. Alignment, X-ray tube with patient, X-ray tube with cassette. Both of them can't be determined due to the absence of collimation, but the cassette with patient can be determined, but then it is incorrect because the distance between the central structure to left side is more than right side. So I've already marked here, the left side is much more compared to the right side. The centering point for this radiograph cannot be determined due to the absence of collimation. The standard centering point is perpendicular to mid-carpal. Next, collimation. At the superior border, can only conclude one because you can just conclude that there's only half of proximal metacarpals. At the inferior border, a quarter of distal end of radius and ulna. But at the right side, you can have the radial styloid, ulna styloid, and the capitate. This is the capitate. At the left side of the border, must be the PC form. Again, the semicircular one. The distal scaphoid, the sharp one, this is a sharp point, and the trapezium, this is the trapezium. Okay, next, with the exposure factor. We'll start off by the contrast, which is affected by the bony cortical outline. For the thin structure, which is the ulna styloid, and the thick structure, which is the distal end radius. So, first, ulna styloid. You can see the ulna styloid right here. Next, the distal end radius. This is the distal end radius. Therefore, concluding that the contrast is adequate and no changes are required in this radiograph. Next, the density, which is affected by the bony trabecular pattern. For the thin structure, yet again, ulna styloid and the thick structure is the distal end radius. So you can still see the bony trabecular of the ulna styloid here and the distal end radius. Therefore, the density is adequate and no changes are required in this image. Marker. Anatomical marker is present in the graph. Placement and notation of marker is correct. Anatomical marker, which is here, does not obscure region of interest. Next, aesthetic value. Size of cassette used is 18x24 cm, which is sufficient to retrieve the information required from the projection. There is no form of artifact on the radiograph. Name. The patient's information regarding to the name, IC number, examination date, and place of examination, etc., are not visualized on the radiograph. I suggest that the name or the patient's identification should be visualized at the borders at the inferior border of the radiograph, not superimposing region of interest. To conclude, the radiograph's positioning is correct. There's no form of radiation just now. The alignment is acceptable, even though there is no collimation, as regions of interest are not obscured or cut off. You can still see every part that needs to be seen as a lateral ridge. Next, exposure factor. Exposure factor is sufficient. You can visualize the thin and thick structure. Anatomical marker is present and placed correctly. There is no form of artifact on the radiograph. But the crucial part is the patient's identification, which is absent on the radiograph. Therefore, radiograph is unacceptable due to absence of patient's identification. These are my references list. You can go to my references list for further explanation, or you can just ask me later. Thank you. Assalamualaikum.